Look like you have some dust on you from when we picked you up. I'm gonna try and get that off. Okay. Stay still. You don't have to be scared, it's okay. Yeah, just put it over there. That's Dahlia. She's what you would call a receptionist. My name is Pepper. Okay, that looks good. So what we're going to do is I'm going to put this lock on you. It's something we have to do with all our participants to make sure that they don't run away. Though you would have no reason to. So, while I get this unlocked, let me just tell you a little bit about what's going on. So, you have been picked up by our ship to be examined to see if you would be a proper donor for our queen back home on our planet. She has been, there we go. She has been suffering with an illness. Can you see her arm, please? She has been suffering with an illness for a pretty long time, and we've been traveling all over the universe on different kinds of planets to see if we could find a proper blood donor for her. So far we've had no success, but I am very, very hopeful for today. So, what I'm going to do is, yes, it does look like your room. No, we come down and we scan your room and then we paste it onto the interior of one of our rooms on the ship to make you feel more comfortable. So, it may look like it's your room, but it's just one of the rooms that we have on the ship. So first thing we're gonna do is I'm just going to, if you hear anything, that's just people walking about the ship. It's just totally fine, people interacting with each other, it's fine. What I'm going to do is just take down some information. That's the first thing I'm going to need. So, first off, I would like to know your name. First and last. Okay. Okay, take a look. Have I spelled this correctly? Okay. The next thing I need to know is how old you are. Do you know how old you are? And when is your birthday, your date of birth? I need that too. And also I'm going to need your parents' names. So, can you tell me your mother's name? And what was her last name before? And your father's name? Now, do you know exactly where you were born? It's okay if you don't. We can use some records for your parents. That's why I ask for their names, so that we can figure out where you were born. So it's okay if you don't know. Do you know how tall you are? No, that's fine. I can measure you. That's fine. Just put that down. And how about how much you weigh? And is that the last time you checked? Okay, and how recent was that? So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take this measuring tool that we have here, and I'm just going to see how tall you are. It works a little differently than a regular measuring tape. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to place it around your neck like this, and it's going to tell me how tall you are. So I'm just going to place this around your neck. No time will pass. No, the time on here is very different. So, when we put you back in your bed, barely a minute will have passed. So, if you have any important things that you need to do in the morning, you'll be able to do them. We do have medication that we give you at the end of the session, because some people do experience some fatigue after tonight, or other nights of this. So I'll give you a couple of these and you'll just fall back asleep. I look what? Yes. Well, this isn't how I really look when we go to different planets. Every session we do to pick up someone, we look at them and look at the things that they like, posters or books, and we try to copy that physically to give a more comfortable experience for people. Yes, I think our last stop was somewhere in Japan, I think. So I understand if this doesn't quite look very. And we mix and match what people have. And we put it all together for ourselves in our own little way, so. Fact, I hope you don't mind me saying so, but, I really like your face. It looks really kind. I was wondering if you would let me scan it. No. We scan people's faces. The people that we scan are people who don't really get noticed, if you know what I mean. When we get our information from the patient, such as yourself, We do a full look back on the people that they've met to make sure that you won't see anyone you recognize. So, I mean, you've never seen this face before, have you? No. And there's a 99.9% chance you will never see it again. So, but I do really like your face. It's very, very kind looking. And I might use it if you let me for the next session, for the next person. Yeah? Okay, this isn't gonna hurt. I'm just going to scan your face using this. It's just gonna be a little blue light, like that. I'm just gonna scan your face, and then it'll be on our database, and then I can use it later on. Shh, we're not gonna tell anyone about this, okay? So just look straight ahead. Mm-hmm. Do this a couple more times. Then, can I get the side of your face? Mm-hmm. The other side. Yep. Thank you. So now that will go in our database, and I'll be able to use it later. And then after I'm caught being sneaky, they'll either delete the face, or everyone else will be able to use it. I just want to be able to use it first. Okay. So the next thing we're going to do is I'm going to check your eyes just to make sure you can see okay. And for that, I have this light on this square platform. Sometimes we decorate it to make it look a little more calm, but I'm just gonna have a little look in your eyes just to see if everything looks okay. Okay, so I'm going to go look at your left eye. Mm-hmm. Can you look up for me? Okay, that looks fine. And your right eye. Mm-hmm. And yep, look up. Okay, that all looks good. So, I'm just going to, where did I put my notebook? There it is. I've lost my pen too. I have so much stuff set out. Ah, there it is. Okay. Okay, so I'm just going to lay that down. Okay, so the next thing that we're going to do is I'm going to just be checking your hair and your scalp to make sure that you know, everything's fine. So I'm just going to be touching your scalp and just touching your hair to see the kind of texture it is. Sometimes for a species like us, that can affect who we can give blood to and who we can't. Okay? So I'm just going to touch your hair a little bit. Feel around your scalp. Okay. Mm-hmm. Your hair feels fine. All looks good. Okay. So then, let me write that down. Everything is A-okay when it comes to your hair. Okay. So the next thing we're going to do is a small skin sample. that won't hurt, but kind of just feel like just something scratchy on you. And for that, we're going to use this very, very, very little knife. It's not really a knife. It's more of just like a little razor. It's not going to hurt at all. We can take it from your face or from your arm. Anywhere. Where do you feel more comfortable with that? On your arm? Okay. So just hold out your arm. Okay. That's all we need for that. So I'm going to put that in here. And then we're also going to need to take a little blood. We don't usually take it in the way that you do. We're just going to use the same object. And just take a little nick at the skin. Nothing more than if you cut yourself shaving or, you know. So, we can also do your arm or your face or your arm again. Okay, do you want to use the other one this time? Okay, so, grab your arm. Thank you. Okay, so I'll be putting this in a container. In a different container. But they all look the same. Okay. Alright. So that's it for the blood sample. So that is, I'm actually going to do one other test before you go. Just a precautionary measure. It's another eye test just to make exactly sure. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to have you follow this pen. You can look at my nose or my eyes or just somewhere in this general area. And I just want you to follow the pen wherever it goes. Okay? Okay. Here we go. Pay very close attention, because I may just go really fast. I'm joking. Okay. So that's the last test. So Dahlia, the receptionist, is going to walk you out. And what's going to happen is that we are going to take you back to your real room. And Dahlia, I'm going to give Dahlia these. And you just take one or two, depending on how tired you feel. And when you wake up in the morning, it'll be nothing more than a dream. And then before we send you down, Dahlia is going to hand you a questionnaire, and you're just going to fill out how good or bad we did. How good or bad I did, stuff like that, so that we can learn for the next person and on and on and on. When you get back, Dahlia will also give you an energy bar that you can take if you're still feeling really sluggish in the morning. So you can eat the energy bar, and then it'll be the same type of caffeine you would get in a coffee, and you'll be able to go through your work day pretty normal. Okay, so that's all. Thank you for being very patient. I'm just going to take the cuff off of you. And then you'll be on your way out. Okay? I always get these keys mixed up. There we are. Okay, and Dahlia, key? Yeah. Okay, thank you very, very much. You won't be seeing us again, not anytime soon. So we're going to review your results, and if you are a match, we will be coming back. And if you're not, you just won't see us again. But I'll be sure to keep this look so that you'll remember everything that happened today, if you are a match. Okay?